Hi, my name is Chris and this is Battle Nonsense. When you record your gameplay, then the audio of the game, microphone and Discord, TeamSpeak or whatever voice over IP solution you use to talk to your friends usually get meshed up into a single audio track. If you record your gameplay just for yourself, then this is not necessarily an issue. But if you want to share it with others or use it on your YouTube channel, then you might want to just record the audio of the game, or you want to be able to manipulate these audio sources individually so that you can then adjust the volume or use filters like noise reduction. I've been using such a setup for a very long time now, which I briefly mentioned in my Shadowplay Alternatives video. So today I will show you how you can achieve that in 4 simple steps without spending a single cent on additional audio hardware or software. That said, if you like the software that we are going to use here, then you should consider to make a small donation to support the creator of VoiceMeter. Now, what do you need to separate these audio sources? Step 1. Go to vb-audio.com, click on Audio Apps and download the VB cable driver. Then click on the VoiceMeter tab and download VoiceMeter. Step 2. Extract the VoiceMeter setup zip file. Run the VoiceMeter setup and install the audio device software. Then extract the VB cable zip file and move it to a safe place on your hard drive, like near the installation directory of VoiceMeter. Then right-click on the VB cable setup, select Run as admin, install the driver, and then reboot your system. Step 3. Now right-click on the speaker symbol, select Playback Devices, find VoiceMeter input, select it, and click on Set Default. Now all applications will send their audio to VoiceMeter. Next, go to the Windows Start menu, type in Voice, and click on VoiceMeter. In case that you increase the text size in Windows, you might get a very large VoiceMeter window. To fix that, you right-click on VoiceMeter, then right-click on the VoiceMeter entry at the top of the list, select Properties, go to Compatibility, and tell VoiceMeter to ignore the Windows DPI value. Then close and reopen VoiceMeter for the changes to become active. Since all applications send their audio to VoiceMeter now, you must ensure that it is always running, or you will not get any audio at all. To do that, you click on Menu and select System Tray Run at Startup. Now you must tell VoiceMeter what it should do with the audio that it receives. So you click on A1 and select the speakers of your sound card. In case that you also use the digital out or any other output on your sound card, you can select that for A2. So now the audio of all applications goes to the virtual input of VoiceMeter, which then sends that audio to the speakers and the digital output of my sound card. But we don't want all applications to use that virtual input. We want that our voice over IP tools like Discord, TeamSpeak and Skype use the virtual audio cable so that we get separate tracks for the game audio and voice over IP. To achieve that, you go to the audio settings inside your voice over IP software, select your microphone as input device and cable input as output device. Now Discord will send its audio to the cable input device, which means that you can use that as a separate audio track. But we still want to hear what our friends have to say, so you have to come back to VoiceMeter and select cable output as an input device. Now the audio of our voice over IP software, as well as the audio from any other application, is sent to hardware out A1 and A2. If you are not scared of VoiceMeter Banana's more complex UI, then you can do one very cool thing with that version of the software. Here you can say that you do not want to hear the audio of the voice over IP software on your surround sound system, which is connected to A2, the digital out of the sound card. This means that when you talk to your friends on Discord, then you will only hear them through the speakers of your headset, but not on the surround sound system, which might be playing some music. So that is all that you have to do to provide your recording software with separate sources for the audio of your game, voice over IP, and your microphone. One thing that you must be aware of is that driver updates might change your default playback device. Should this happen, then you might not get any audio at all, or in case that your monitor supports it, you might suddenly have your PC use the speakers built into your monitor. When this happens, then you only have to go to your playback devices, select VoiceMeter input, and make it your default audio device again. Step 4. Now that Windows provides all these different audio sources, we just have to tell our recording software what it should do with them. In DXTory, you go to Audio and change the first audio device to VoiceMeter input, which is the audio of the game. Then you add a second audio stream where you select cable input, which is the audio of your VoiceOver IP software. And lastly, you add a third track, which is your microphone. So now all your recordings will come with three different audio tracks that you can then easily manipulate in the video editing software of your choice. The setup process is very similar in other tools like Bandicam or Action. However, not all screen capture tools allow you to have more than two audio tracks. Shadowplay does not even allow you to select the primary audio device. So due to the limitations of these tools, you will probably only use them when you want to record just the audio of the game with no chatter. The software that I use to capture my gameplay is OBS. To set up these three different audio tracks there, you go to Settings and then Audio. For the desktop audio device, you select Voice Meter Input. For the desktop audio device 2, you select Cable Input. And for the mic, you select your microphone. Then right-click on the audio sources inside the mixer and rename them. Then right-click again and select Advanced Audio Properties. In here you then set Game Audio to track 1, VoiceOver IP to track 2, and your mic to track 3. Now go back to the settings again, select Output, and change the output mode from Simple to Advanced. Then click on the Audio tab and enter the names of the audio tracks. You can also change the bitrate here if you want to. Now you must tell OBS to record these audio tracks. So you go to Recording and enable audio tracks 1, 2 and 3. I use the TS or Transport Stream recording format because the recorded video file will then survive a crash of the game, your system or OBS. Also Adobe Premiere can handle TS files with multiple audio tracks. But I won't dive deeper into the video recording settings in this video here, as that is a very big subject where the best configuration will strongly depend on your personal needs and your hardware. However, you might want to check out the video I link to in the description down below, where I explain how I use a second graphics card as NVE and C encoder to reduce the impact that recording with OBS has on the performance of the game. What I do want to talk about a bit is what you can do when the game capture source can't hook into the process of the game that you want to capture, which means that it can't record the game then. Destiny 2 actively blocks any and all external tools, so you can't record that game when it runs in exclusive fullscreen mode. But for any other game, you can try to select the process directly inside the properties of the game capture source. If it still doesn't work, then you should try to run OBS as admin. I actually changed the OBS shortcut properties to always run it as admin, as that usually prevents that issue from happening on my system. If the game capture source still can't capture your game, then you should check if you have any other tools running in the background which provide an in-game overlay, like MSI Afterburner or the standalone version of RTSS. You might also want to try and disable the overlays provided in Origin, Steam or Uplay. So that's it! You can now either record all three audio sources separately and manipulate them in the video editing software of your choice, or you can just record the audio of the game without any chatter. Let me know in the comments what you think about this setup, and if you have an idea for a tutorial that I should do in the future, then I would love to hear it. If you enjoyed this little tutorial, then it would be great if you could support me on Patreon, as it's the awesome support that I get from my Patreons which keeps Battle Nonsense alive. You can find a link to my Patreon in the description down below, where you can also find links to my social accounts in case that you want to stay up to date on the videos that I'm working on. So if you enjoyed this video, then please give it a like, subscribe for more, and I hope to see you next time. Until then, have a nice day and take care. My name is Chris, and this was Battle Nonsense.